Symmetries imply conservation. So it turns out there's something much more fundamental about conservation laws, and they arise from symmetries in the universe.
Whoa, wait. You mean these imply conservation? Not those. I mean these.
No matter how you spin this fully spherical Earth, you couldn't change the physics of it.
The forces acting on it, its energy, it would all be the same. This object has continuous rotational symmetry, or maybe this platform, which you could move around to anywhere in this vast emptiness, and in all cases, its energy and the forces acting on it would be the same. That is continuous translational symmetry. Finally, we have time translational symmetry. That is when an object remains the same over time, it doesn't decay, and its energy remains constant. These symmetries give rise to different kinds of conservation, and each of these symmetries has a corresponding conserved quantity, namely linear momentum for translational symmetry, angular momentum for rotational symmetry, and energy for time translation symmetry. These relations between symmetries and conservation were observed by the German mathematician Emil Noether, hence we call it Noether's theorem. Symmetries are observed in all aspects of nature, and they are observed even in the quantum world. The symmetries that we discussed are also found in the quantum world, we just have to look at them. In quantum mechanics, all quantum particles seem to act as a wave, which we describe as its wave function, giving us probabilities of finding that object in a particular position. Now, what happens before we find the particle is a matter of debate. All we know is that the act of measuring a quantum particle changes something about it. The wave function collapses into the delta function. This wave-like thing chooses one particular state and starts acting like a regular object. This means that a particle could be found here or here, and it might choose one of many different possible values of energy or momentum. Just like normal waves in the classical world change with time, in the quantum world too, the wave functions change with time, and the way they change is what we call time evolution. Here, the symmetries are observed as such. Say we have a wave function and we translate this to here. We would say this wave function has translational symmetry if, even after the translation, it changes the same way over time. Basically, it experiences the same time evolution. The same principle applies for rotational symmetry, given the wave function experiences the same time evolution. Here, time translation symmetry applies when the average expected value or the mean of the energy of the wave function remains the same, even after time evolution, and this implies conservation of energy. Noether's theorem is one of the most fundamental ideas in all of physics, which acts as a proof for something we all consider to be fundamental in itself, conservation. But what is more fascinating is that this theorem does not only apply to classical mechanics, but rather, we can observe this even in quantum mechanics, which must come as a shock because almost every intuitive description of reality in classical mechanics is challenged by quantum mechanics. And Noether's theorem is one of the very few ideas that are observed in both the large and the small.